Born in Hampshire, England, in 1960, to Polish-Jewish immigrant parents, Neil Gaiman grew to be an imaginative child who craved books and devoured every one that he could get his hands on. After moving to Sussex, England, in 1965, Gaiman attended a number of Church of England schools, such as Ardingly Prep College, where he spent most of his free time in the library studying the card catalog and reading his way through the entire children's collection. It was here that he developed his lifelong love for reading and writing, while local librarians opened his eyes to titles and authors he may not have otherwise read. Upon completing his education, Gaiman began pursuing journalism as a career, conducting interviews and focusing on book reviews and rock journalism. At the age of 24, he wrote his first book, which was a Duran Duran biography that took him 3 months to complete. In 1989, he began writing the groundbreaking 75-issue graphic novel series, The Sandman, which was the first comic ever to receive a literary award, the 1991 World Fantasy Award for Best Short Story. Gaiman is credited with being not just one of the creators of modern comics, but as an author whose work reaches audiences of all ages. His work can be classified in a number of different genres, ranging from horror, fantasy, science fiction, comedy, and mystery, and often he jumps from one genre to another within a single work. His work, in fact, falls under a wide variety of formats, including graphic novels, short stories, children's books, poems, novels, plays, and scripts for television and film. In 1993, 1 year after moving to Minneapolis, Minnesota, Neil Gaiman began a comedic collaboration with his longtime mentor, Terry Pratchett. The two English writers soon produced Gaiman's first novel, Good Omens, which uses slapstick comedy to address the most serious of subjects, the end of humankind. Gaiman's works are inspired by authors he read as a young boy, such as the Mary Poppins stories of Pamela Travers, who he says influenced what he wrote and how he wrote it, as well as The Jungle Book of R. Kipling, which greatly influenced Gaiman's own The Graveyard Book. Both stories parallel the life of an orphaned boy who is forced to grow up in an out-of-the-ordinary setting and learns the ways of its residents. Along with the influence of Kipling, Gaiman brought inspiration from his personal life to fuel this story, which came about 26 years ago as Gaiman watched his then 2-year-old son ride his tricycle around gravestones, thinking of how comfortable and happy he looked. The writing stopped soon after it had begun, when he realized he could not continue writing because he had not been a parent for long enough. Gaiman reflects on the experience by saying, "The book was built on the foundation of having been a parent, having raised children, and having let them go out into the world on their own." His ideas for this book gestated for nearly 2 decades, when he completed the book after having 3 children of his own. Published in 2008, Neil Gaiman's The Graveyard Book is a tale of Nobody Owens, a human boy who was raised in a graveyard. The boy came to the graveyard as a toddler, having escaped his family's murderer known as the Man Jack. Nobody Owens is raised and tutored by the inhabitants of the graveyard, most of whom are dead, and learns special talents such as fading in order to live in the graveyard undetected and safe from the Man Jack, who is still searching for him. Neil Gaiman went on to win numerous awards for this book, including the 2009 Newbery Medal for his contribution to American literature for children, and the 2009 Hugo Award for Best Novel in the Science Fiction Fantasy genre. American Gods is a fantasy novel for adults that centers on the idea that the gods we believe in walk among us. But as religion falls by the wayside and Americans begin to worship money, television, and power, the old gods find themselves threatened, no longer thriving as they once had, with this contest between old and new eventually sparking a war. It is also the third of Gaiman's novels to be adapted for the screen, following films Stardust and Coraline, and should make its debut on HBO in 2013 as a 6-season series. Gaiman's stories are immersed with aspects of his childhood and personality. As with the parents of Coraline Jones in his 2002 young adult novel Coraline, where Gaiman describes a sense of deep detachment, which he says is a parody of himself. The beautiful Victorian home that houses the quirky characters of this story was inspired by a home Neil Gaiman lived in as a child. Coraline went on to win the 2003 Nebula Award and the 2002 Bram Stoker Award. The story is about a young girl named Coraline who is looking for excitement and ventures through a mysterious door into a world that is similar, yet disturbingly different from her own, where she must challenge a gruesome entity in order to save herself, her parents, and the souls of three others. Gaiman is quoted as saying, "Prose fiction is the nearest we'll get to the experience of looking out of someone else's eyes, of seeing things from the point of view of someone that is not us." Much of Gaiman's work can be characterized as prose fiction, including the 2003 children's book, The Wolves in the Walls, which is about a young girl named Lucy who is sure there are wolves living in the walls of her home. Her family does not believe her, and the day the wolves come out, Lucy's battle with the creatures is just the beginning of this family's adventures with what lives behind their walls. The pleasantly ominous mood of Neil Gaiman's writing is present even in his children's picture books. The Dangerous Alphabet is a unique twist on an ordinary alphabet book and takes readers on an adventure of danger and piracy as two children follow a treasure map through an underground city where monsters and pirates roam. Odd and the Frost Giants is another of Neil Gaiman's books that takes place in an alternate world. This short novel, that was inspired by traditional Norse mythology, was written for the UK World Book Day. It is about a 12-year-old boy who is forced on a strange journey to save the city of Asgard, the city of the gods, from the frost giants who have invaded it. Neil Gaiman's recognition has earned him a spot in the Dictionary of Literary Biography as one of the top 10 living postmodern writers, as well as cameo appearances on popular television cartoons such as The Simpsons and Arthur. Neil Gaiman is quoted as saying, "The literature of the imagination is just that, stories which take readers to places they haven't been, to see things they haven't imagined, to see how things could be different." Being a successful writer for almost 30 years now, Neil Gaiman is very aware of the rules of writing fiction, but rarely follows them, and instead follows the endless depths his imagination will allow him to go.